Hi there, welcome back to Physicals Fashion Now's channel. I'm Fola and I'll teach you how to sew this classic kimono jacket. As you can see, this jacket is made with an industrial sewing concept. It has a very neat finishing and well-arranged pattern. You should watch to the end, and if you have not subscribed to my channel, click to the subscribe button now. Thank you. So, make your kimono jackets. These are all the things you need. You need your fabric, interfacing, and then lining, then your rulers. The fabric is unfolded, and the length of a jacket is a 42. You add 2 inches to the length, so giving us 44. I'm sewing for size 12. The bust of the person is 37, the waist is 33, and the hip is 43. So, I first of all get the lapel allowance. So, you can use 2 inches as your lapel allowance. You can use 2.5 or 3. So, I'm using 2.5 here. So, you get your 2.5 here. Mark your 2.5. Then rule down. You rule it down. Then you get the shoulder of the person. The shoulder is 15 divided by 2 is 7.5, then plus half, making 8. So every of your measurement now will start after the lapel line. So then you get your bust line, which is a 9. You roll it down from the shoulder. That is. Bust line where your bust will be measured. Then you measure your bust. The bust of the person is 37. We had 3 to hit, which is 40, divided by 4, give us 10. You measure 10. Then sewing allowance 1. You get the half length of the person, which is 19. Is the half length on it? You measure the. On it, you measure the waist. On the half length, you measure the waist of the person. The waist of the person is 33. You had 3. Give us 36. 36 divided by 4. It gives us 9. You measure 9. You don't need to consider that in this one. 9, then sewing allowance 1. From your half length, you measure 8 down to get your hip. This is where you are going to measure your hip. The hip of the person is 43. You have 3, give us 46. 46 divided by 4, give us 11.5. 11.5. Then sewing allowance 1. Then at the down part here, you just get the same thing you get here in your hip. So everything like 13, and that's what you get at the down part here, 13. So then you connect. Before we connect a bust to the waist and waist to the down part, let me quickly take care of the up part here. Here you measure 3. The wideness of your neck, you measure 3. To come down, I mean the depth of your neck, 3. Then here, you measure 2.5 here. Then you rule it. you rule everything to the down. Then from here you slantly rule it, the 3 inches you measure up here, you slantly rule it, you join the 2.5 you measure down here. Then you just cuff your hand a little here. We don't want this place to sharp. Then you, in your shoulder, you come down on the bust line here. At the upper part, you come down with one. Then you slantly link it to the wideness of your neck. Then here, on this bust line, you get the midpoint, which is 4.5. You come in by one. Then you link this to the up here to join the coming down from the bust line. This is now you use your armhole cuff to link the shoulder to your arm to get your armhole. Now you link the bust to the waist. Then waist to the hip part. Then to the down part. So you take care, you can use your cuff to take care of this part so that it will not be too sharp. See. So you now come to take care of your lapel now. So it depends on the way you want it. So but it's always good for you to come today to your underbust. Like this person, the Honda bust is 16. So it is on the 16 point that we now determine the lapel. So that is the lapel will reach under the bust here. Because it's not a normal jacket or normal blazer. This is a kimono. So here now, we come out by one. By one. At the down part here, you measure one. Then you connect it. That will serve as a button allowance in case you are putting button on your jacket. But it's not mandatory. You may put button, you might not. This one we are not putting button. So from this end, you link it to the up part. So this is the lapel part. By the time we cut it out, you will see the lapel will reflect. So I want to cut it out now. So thereafter, after we are going to put our interfacing, and this is what we are going to, this is the lapel now. This is the way lapel is going to look. Like after joining the collar, you will see the finished part of it. So we are going to cut the back now. Cut the back of your kimono jacket. We have gotten the length, which is a 44. This 0.75. I measure 0.75 here. I measured it down here and I rolled it down. This one want to, this very line want to serve to shape our back, so that our cloth will have a shape at the back. So as we proceed in the teaching, you will see the useful of this one. So to get, you get your shoulder, which is a 8. The bust line, 9. You connect it. Then, wideness of your neck, 3. And you come down by 1. You connect it together. You come down your shoulder by 1 to slant your shoulder. You connect it to the wideness of your neck. You get the midpoint of your bust line, which is a 4.5. Then you come in by 1/2 for the back. In the front we came in by 1. Here you come in with 1/2. You connect it. Then the bust. The bust of the person after division give us 10. You know, it was 37, we added 3, making 40 divided by 4, give us 10. Then sewing allowance 1. The half back is 17.5. You know, the half length of the person is 19. So you deduct 1.5 from half length to get your half back. So it's 17.5. On it, you measure your waist. And the waist of the person is 33 plus, we added 3, giving us 36 divided by 4, give us 9. 9. Then sewing allowance, 1. From half back, you come down by 8. On it, you measure your hip. The hip of the person is 43 plus 3, that's 46 divided by 4, give us 11.5. Sewing allowance. 1. So making almost 13 now. So the down part, you make the down part the same thing as a hip. Or if you want your home to be like a shape, you can add like 2 to your hip. But this one we are doing it straight. Then we connect it. You get your hammer. Now to this line now. So on this point, on this half back, you just slantly roll to the hip line. You know, we came down by 8 to get our hip. So on that hip line, now slantly from that half back, you connect it slantly to the hip line. So then from there, you slantly connect to the up part. So this will give your jacket shape. It will not be puffing out at the back there. This is our back cut. So we're going to cut this. Then here, you open your bag. So when you get to this point where you roll down to the hip line, so remember your ruling there and begin to, you are cutting out, this you are cutting out now is what will make your back to fit and not pumping out. So this is the back cut of the jacket. Now this is the back cut, and we have cut a lining for the back cut. So this is the lining for the back cut. So from this lining of the back cut, we deduct two from down here, so that by the time you fold it in, after joining it with cutter, then you fold it in, so you will see the end result of this later. So this is the front cut. This is the lining. After cutting the lining for the front cut, I have to shear that lining because we need interfacing for the front. So all you need to do after cutting the lining of the front is for you to measure the shoulder of your fabric. Then you divide it into two. You mark it. Then you mark it down here. For the line, you rule it, then you shear into two. You shear it. After shearing it, so the side, this side of the lining, you cut the material, your fabric out. You cut the fabric out, and then you paste your interfacing on it. So this will serve as a lapel. After joining it, it will serve as a facing. Then the lapel will come out of it after joining it. So this is the way it's going to be now. After joining this half, now will be joined to with this one. So we sew it down. So thereafter, we now come and join this one to the real to the body of our jacket. This place will now serve as a lapel. It's going to be like this. So now, let's go and join everything together now. Now, we have joined the lining and the main fabric together. This is the wrong side of our fabric. You can see after joining the lining and the facing together, this is the result. See how neat it is. This is the back. You can see how it is neatly sewn. We have joined the center back together. So this place, we cut out like 2.5 inches at the upper part of the back. Then we replace it with the main fabric. So to give it a neat and perfect finishing. To achieve our lapel. This is the lapel now. This is how it's going to be after putting a collar. So it is after putting collar that we iron our lapel very well. So we top stitch it. When you are doing your top stitching, you top stitch in such a way that when you open your, by the time you arrange your lapel, the top stitching will be under in the front here. So when we are top stitching, we stop under the bust where our lapel started, where we started slanting the lapel. We stop it there, then start the top stitching here again at the back, so that by the time you eventually fold your lapel, the top stitching will be well arranged. The top stitching will be at the back in the lapel and in the remaining part of the fabric. The top stitching will be for neat finishing. So we have joined the shoulder part, fabric to fabric with half inch, fabric to fabric, the lining to lining. The next thing is to measure this neckline to get the measurement for our collar. So we are going to measure from where, because when we were sewing it, we joined the lining and the fabric together from, you know, at initial stage, we use 2.5 as our lapel line. So we start sewing from that 2.5. So now we are going to measure the remaining so as to be able to use it to as guideline to cut our collar. So I'll measure it now. I'll measure it from this place. So from here to this place, now where the shoulder is joined together, we have 4.5. So at the back neckline, we have 7. You can see we have 7. Then this place will be 4.5 again. So you take note of that. That's the guideline we are going to use to cut our collar. We measure our neckline go round. We have 16.5. So we round it up, we had sewing allowance like half, making 17. So by the time we want to fold our collar, we are going to fold it 17 divided by 2, which is 8.5. So that's what we are going to use in cutting our collar. So from there, but after folding it 8.5, we now get the 4.5 that we measure earlier from here to the neckline. We measure it, then we divide this center back, which is 7, divided by 2, 3.5. We measure that one. You will see that when we are drawing the cutting for the collar now. The 16.5 that we measure round the neck in the neckline, we say you had a half to it, making 17. So that's what you get. You get 17 by 8. So the size of your collar is going to be 4 inches, but we make it 8 because we are going to fold it. And you see that it has been neatly padded with interfacing so that the collar will lay very well in your neck. You can use a collar stay or paper stay, the hard one, so that it will make it stay very well. So you iron it to it. So now you are going to fold it. You fold it like this. Then you fold it like this. So after folding it into 2 equal parts like this, then you fold it again like this. Then that 7 that we measured at the center of our back that time, you now divide it by 2, give us 3.5. You measure it 3.5. That's the center back now. Then here, you come down by 1. Then here, that's 4.5 that we, then before that, here you come up with 2.5. 2.5 that you rule down at initial stage when you started as your lapel line. When we started cutting our jacket, that's 2.5 that we rule down in the front. So you measure it here, 2.5, you mark it. then 4.5 that you measure by the side from your lapel to the shoulder point. That 4.5 you had like a, you had half that half sewing allowance. That is where you join it. So giving us 5. So you slantly join it together here. So here, you now connect here. This is the back neck. 3.5, then come down by 1. You connect it. Here, you now come up here by half inch. You slantly roll it down here. So this will make your collar to sit very well in your neck. So this is our collar now. So I'm going to cut it now. Then you cut here. So here, don't cut everything finished so that you won't, the thing will not scatter. So this is our collar now. So we are going to join this place with cutter. Then we join this place with cutter before we now insert it into our jacket. So we'll go and do that now. Then you open it to top stitch this place so that it will lay very well in your neck. So these are collar. It has been well ironed and top stitch. You have top stitched it. So we want to join it to the body of the jacket now. Now, to join the collar to the neckline, this is the neckline. So this is the collar. You notch the center of your collar so that it will be in line with the center back. So the top stitching part will be at the back. So this is the center of our collar. This the center of our back. This is the center. You notch it too. So to insert the collar now. You now place the collar, the notched part, that is the center part of the collar. You insert it inside the center part of the back neck. So you now take it from inside of your jacket. You bring it out. That is where you are going to sew it round. So I'll start from the center to go to the right, then go to the left. So this is it. That's the collar in the mid parts. So you will join it with a cutter. Arranging it so that everything will be perfectly joined. So we'll be arranging it. We'll be opening it. We'll be arranging it so that the margin wouldn't have escaped the collar in there. Then you come to the second half of your neck collar. So you arrange it just the way you did in the first half. You'll be arranging it with your collar inside so that you won't escape any of them. You'll be matching them together to ensure they are line. So make sure you don't draw any part so that one will not, there won't be unnecessary excess. So now the collar has been joined to it. Now we can now use iron to lay our lapel properly to that underbust point. So the next thing now is to go and join our sleeve to it, then our beautiful jacket will be ready. So to get the sleeve of our jacket, you have to measure the armhole. You measure the armhole round. This is the armhole of our jacket. You measure it round. You can pick any one, either lining or the fabric. You measure it round. Here we have a 20. So 20 is our arm hole. So to make the sleeve for our jacket, the person we are sewing for is a 30, the random, you consider the random of the person. The random of the person is 13. So you had 3, making 16. So 16 now divided by 2, give us 8. Then you had like half. So making 8.5. So that you are going to, is 8.5 you are going to use in folding the fabric. You are going to use for the sleeve. You mark 8.5. 8.5. So this fabric is on food. You rule it down. Rule down the 8.5. So which means all your measurements must not exceed that 8.5 points. So you know, initially we have measured the armhole of the jacket. It gives us 20. So that 20 you are going to divide it by 2. give us 10. So it's 10 you are going to consider here now to get your to get the armor for your sleeve. So, and to get that 10, you are going to place your taproom in such a way that it will slant. So, you know, we have not gotten to 10 points. So you shift it a bit down until you achieve that 10. We achieve 10 now. So that point that you are able to achieve 10, you mark it. So that is where you are going to, you will mark slantly from the upper part of your sleeve. You now mark it slantly to that point. That's how you get the end of your sleeve. So you now measure it again to ensure that it gives you 10. So you can see it gives us 10. If it's more than 10, you shift it a bit up. So it gives us 10 now. So for the down part, you are going to measure, you deduct 3 from that 9. So it gives you 6. You mark 6 or 5.5 so that it will be fitted by your wrist. So you now roll it down, slantly roll it down. I mean, from the 8.5, you deduct 3 down here. It gives you 5.5. So this down part now, you measure up like 3 inches. 3 inches. So you get your hair stay. You paste hair stay on this down part, 3 inches. So that your hand will be, the wrist part of your sleeve will be firm. I'm going to cut out another one of this for the second sleeve. Then I will cut out the lining, the same size. So in the lining, I will deduct 2. This is the length of this sleeve is 25, so the lining I will deduct 2, giving us 23, so as to be used to fold it in just the way we did in the fourth body of the jacket. So, but here we are going to paste our hair stay or gum stay here. Then join the sleeve lining and fabric to the jacket, and your beautifully sewn kimono jacket is ready. I'm sure you learned a lot. So please give this video a thumbs up, comment below, and share it to your friends. Love you!